Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha Girivar Dhari. Jaya Yashoda Nandana Braj Jana Ranjana. Yashoda Nandana Braj Jana Ranjana. Yamuna Tira Vanachari. Yamuna Tira Vanachari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. 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 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. We are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11, Chapter 18, Text Number 5. Chapter entitled Description of Varnashram Dharma. Please recite. Agni Pakvam Samashniyat. Kala pakvam athapi va ulu khalashma utto va danto lukhala eva va agni pakvam samashniyat kala pakvam athapi va Ulu khalashma kuttova danto lukhala eva va agni pakvam samashniyat kala pakvam athapi va ulu khalashma kuttova Danto lukhala eva va. Mataji's. Hare Krishna. Agni by fire. Pakvam made ready to eat. Samashniyat, one should eat. Kala by time. Pakvam, right for eating. Athah, else. Api, indeed. Va, or. Ulukhala, with grinding mortar. Ashma, and stone. Kutaha, pulverized, ground up. Va, or. Danta, using the teeth. Ulukhala, as a grinding mortar. Ev, indeed. Va, or alternatively. Translation and purport by the disciples of His Divine Grace, Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada. Translation. One may eat foodstuffs prepared with fire, such as grains, or fruits ripened by time. One may grind one's food with mortar and stone or with one's own teeth. Purport. In Vedic civilization, it is recommended that at the end of one's life, one should go to a holy place or forest for spiritual perfection. In sacred forests, one does not find restaurants, supermarkets, fast food chains, and so on. And thus, one must eat simply, reducing sense gratification. Although the Western countries' people eat processed food, one living simply must himself separate and pulverize grains and other foods before eating. This is referred to here. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda. Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. I'll read the translation once again. One may eat foodstuffs prepared with fire, such as grains or fruits ripened by time. One may grind one's food with mortar on stone or with one's own teeth. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. So this is a description of Vanaprastha Ashram. We have been hearing the description of Varanashram. So this is Vanaprastha. Several verses are given. We have four ashrams: Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyas. And how one should enter Vanaprastha Ashram is described in detail. The whole principle in this series of verses is described that one should simplify one's life. One should take to the path of austerity. Like yesterday, Gopinath Chandra Prabhu was mentioning from the divine qualities in chapter 16 of Bhagavad Gita, that how abhayam sattva samshuddhir jnana yoga vyavasthita danam damascha yagyascha swadhyaya tapaha arjavam. This tapasya is mentioned for specifically vanaprasthas. And a lot of description is given that how one should keep one's hairs, one's dress, one's food. I was thinking, anyway, because vanaprastha is the next 50% of the life is over, first 50%, then you enter the third part of the life, which if nowadays an average person lives for 70 years, at 35 his vanaprastha starts. And by 35 or 40, anyway, digestion has become very poor. So you can hardly eat anything. And so I think tapasya is automatically a part of the life. Like I was at one place giving class and we were discussing about the glories of dudhi sabji, dudhi and bhopla, which are not two very famous sabjis. It was mentioned that when God wanted to give bad karma, jab Bhagavan ko sara karma ek saath kisi ko dena tha, to pehle patni ko banaya, phir patni ko dudhi aur bhopla banane ki kala sikha di, sara karma ek saath mil gaya. So dudhi and bhopla is not considered very good, but in that class everybody was telling that after 40 somehow most of them like dudhi and bhopla only, because that is the only thing they could digest and that is the only thing they could handle, and they were having a very wonderful life. About the old age, these are just some of the starter points before we enter the Leela. In the old age, it is mentioned, jaise jaise aadmi boodha hota hai aur mehenga hota jata hai, uske baalon mein chandi aati hai, daanton mein sona aata hai, aankhon mein moti aata hai, kidney mein mehenge mehenge patthar aate hain, aur blood mein high sugar ho jata hai. So some simplicity and some tapasya is forced upon us as a part of old age. But then it is still mentioned that one should cultivate simplicity and tapasya and simplify one's needs. Like there was one quote which says, if you have a dream, like we have a dream that our vanaprastha, as age grows, as age progresses, our life should become simple. Tapasya should become easy, or tapasya should be included. So that's tapasya is our dream. So it is mentioned, a dream should be written with some date fixed. It becomes a goal. When you have a dream and you have a date fixed, by this date I have to fulfill the dream, it becomes a goal. When the goal is broken down into steps, it becomes a plan. And when a plan is backed up by an action, it becomes a reality. So that simple life or austere life should become a goal, broken down into steps, become a plan, backed up by an action, becomes a reality. We have this sutra of our life match, M-A-T-C-H. Mercy, austerity, truthfulness, cleanliness, and holy name. So austerity is a very important part of the four pillars of dharma. In his book Prema Vivarta, Sri Jagdanand Pandit says, Vairagi bhai gramya katha na shunibe, gramya varta na kahibe. My dear brother, you are in the renounced order of life. You should not listen to the talk about worldly things, nor should you talk about worldly things when you meet with others. Do not think of women even in dreams. So it is mentioned you are in renounced order. Do not discuss, do not speak worldly things. The funny part is that in spite of hearing this verse many times, sometimes the person is discussing worldly things but doesn't feel that he is discussing worldly things. I was going to Baramati in the train on the way to Don, and I was sitting on the side berth, upper sleeper, and two ladies were constantly talking. And how their conversation started? Their conversation started that वैसे हमें दूसरों की बुराई तो नहीं करनी चाहिए. And then they spoke 3 hours of every person they knew under the planet, under the sky. And then they ended, वैसे क्या करें हमें दूसरों के जीवन से क्या मतलब? So after 3 hours talking about gramya katha, so this is kind of most conditioned soul story. Lot of pleasure in gramya katha and lot of dryness in holy name, in conditioned state. And then it says, Swapne ona kara bhai stri sambhashan grihe stri chhariya bhai asi achevan. Yadi chaha pranaya rakhite gaurangerasane chota hari dasera katha thake yena mani. It says, do not think of women even in dreams. You have accepted the renounced order of life with a vow that forbids you to associate with women. If you wish to associate with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you must always remember the incidents of Chota Haridas and how he was rejected by the Lord. So a lot of emphasis about what kind of association you take, what kind of dress you wear, what kind of food you eat. But if you see, this is absolutely in a different direction because the whole world is going in a different direction. Like there was a girl who was supposed to get married to a boy and marriage broke and the father decided girl should be married to someone else. And finally the marriage was taking place. And father of the girl was welcoming everyone in the marriage. And finally this boy comes up, whom the girl was supposed to get married previously. And this father didn't know that who is that boy, and father saw him and he says, who are you? We didn't invite you. He said, actually my story is, main semi-final mein out ho gaya tha, final match dekhne aaya hoon. So there is so much meditation on worldly pleasures. But here it is telling, do not even think in dreams. And then the last part which says, Bhalana khaibe yaar bhalana paribe hridayate Radha Krishna sarvada sevibe. Do not eat luxurious dishes or dress in fine garments. Always remain humble and serve their lordship. Shri Shri Radha Krishna, in your heart of hearts. Again, we hear Prabhupada quotes this Bhaktivinoda Thakur's prayer, Sharira Avidya Jal Jodendriya Taheka Jive Fele Vishaya Sagore. Tar Madhe Jivayati Lobho Maya Sudurmati. Very difficult this tongue. Most difficult. So tongue is mentioned most difficult, and therefore in Vanaprastha so many things are mentioned that now you have come out of the worldly enjoyment. So please, so as the purport says, we do not find restaurants in sacred forests. We do not find supermarkets. We do not find fast food chains and so on. Imagine our Govinda's restaurant is so famous. I went to a program and this one boy was showing me a video which shows Govinda's lifestyle. Which Govinda? The Bollywood Govinda. And looks like the person who made the video, he collected everything on the word Govinda. And I was surprised to see in that video, in Govinda's lifestyle, there were several pictures of Juhu Govinda, Chowpatty Govinda. I mean, different ISKCON temples Govinda was there. They thought that this Govinda has some connection with this Govinda, and this Govinda has opened many, many restaurants in his own name. So it was a very funny video. I was thinking,
They are thinking Govinda, Bollywood star, has opened all these Govinda restaurants. But they do not know about this Govinda. So our Govinda, our supreme hero. But a lot of attraction to the food is there, and therefore we have all these Govinda's outlets to attract through food. And Govinda's attracts all ashrams equally. That's one thing. But here is telling, do not eat luxurious dishes or dress in fine garments. Now, to understand this and to go into the depth of this, like this one man went into a marriage, and in the marriage he was just eating and eating and eating and eating. See how much inclination we have to eat. He was eating and everybody was watching. Why is he eating? 1 hour is over, 2 hours is over. What is he doing? He said, why are you eating so much? He said, I am also stressed. I can't eat so much. But in the marriage card, it was written dinner timing 7 to 10 p.m. So I thought I have to eat for 3 hours. So there is so much inclination and you'll end up doing something as per your inclination. Now, even Bhagavad Gita at the very outset says, Yuktahar viharasya yukta cheshtasya karmasu yukta svapnavabhodasya yogo bhavati dukha. He who is regulated in his habits of eating, sleeping, recreation and work can mitigate all material pains by practicing yoga system. In the pastime of Brigari, where Lord Chaitanya, this comes in Madhya Leela 24th chapter, text 230 onwards. In the pastime of Mrigari, the beautiful story is described that how Narad Muni goes and preaches to Mrigari. And the last few verses of Mrigari ends that how Mrigari is advised to enter Vanaprastha ashram. So the story goes like this, that how this is a hunter and Narad Muni is coming in the forest path, and Narad Muni sees a deer with an arrow piercing the body, with the legs twisted and broken, and in extreme pain. Then he sees a boar, legs twisted, arrow pierced, in extreme pain. Then he sees a rabbit, arrow pierced, in extreme pain. And then he goes further and he sees this hunter Mrigari sitting there, behind the tree, ready to shoot many more animals, ready to pierce many more animals by the arrow. And Narad Muni goes in the direction of Mrigari, and Mrigari gets very upset because Narad Muni comes there, all the animals run away. And when Mrigari gets very upset, but Mrigari wants to use abusive language to get angry at Narad, but he does not, he refrains, but he introduces himself. He says, I am the enemy, Mrigari, I am the enemy of the animals. That is my introduction. He says, the hunter's body was blackish. He had reddish eyes and he appeared fierce. It was as if the superintendent of death, Yamraj, was standing there with bow and arrows in his hand. Narad Muni replied that I have specifically come here to settle a doubt in my mind. I was wondering whether all the boars and animals that are half killed belong to you. Hunter said, yes, what you are saying is so. Why did you kill the animals completely? Why did you half kill them by piercing their bodies with arrows? The hunter replied, my dear saintly person, my name is Mrigari, enemy of animals. My father taught me to kill them in that way. Now this is an interesting thing. It appears Mrigari was very innocently doing everything. Just because he has learned from his father, he is doing this way. When I see half-killed animals suffer, I feel great pleasure. Narad Muni then told the hunter, I have one thing to beg of you. You may take whatever animals or anything else. You want deer skin? You want tiger skin? Take anything you want. When Narad Muni made a request, what can I do? Mrigari is thinking, this is what I can offer. Anything, tell me, this is most dear to me and I can give it to you. Narad Muni said, I do not want any of the skins. Only one thing I want in charity. I beg you that you will kill animals completely and not leave them half dead. The hunter replied, my dear sir, what are you asking of me? What is wrong with the animals lying there half killed? Will you please explain this to me? Narad Muni gives a whole explanation that how killing these animals half dead, how much sinful, because you are making them suffer so much. If you want to kill, kill them at one shot. Why you are making them suffer like this? So much sinful reaction will come upon you. In this way, through the association of great sage Narad Muni, the hunter was a little convinced of his sinful activity. He therefore becomes somewhat afraid due to the offenses, Prabhupada writes. This is the effect of associating with the pure devotee. Our preachers who are preaching Krishna consciousness all over the world should follow in the footsteps of Narad Muni and become purified by following the four principles and chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. This will make them fit to become Vaishnavas. Then when they speak to sinful people about teachings of this Krishna consciousness movement, people will be affected and take the instructions. We receive instructions in devotional service through disciplic succession, and Narad Muni is our original guru because he is the guru of Vyasadev. Then he says, hunter then admitted that he was convinced of his sinful activity. But I have been taught this business from a very childhood. See, some people might be in a very sinful business because that's the only thing they are taught. But here, in spite of being in a very sinful business, he is ready to take shelter of the association of pure devotee like Narad Muni. He's telling, now I am wondering how I can be freed from these unlimited volumes of sinful activity. Prabhupada says, this kind of admission is very beneficial. As long as one does not again commit sin, cheating and hypocrisy are not tolerated by higher authorities. There is no problem in admitting that I am sinful, but what is not admitted is cheating and hypocrisy. If one understands what sin is, he should give it up with sincerity and regret and surrender. The hunter continued, my dear sir, please tell me how I can be relieved. Now I fully surrender and fall down at your lotus feet. Please deliver me from sinful reactions. Prabhupada writes, by grace of Narad Muni, hunter came to his good senses and immediately surrendered unto the saint's lotus feet. And Narad Muni instructs, first thing is you break your bow, then I will tell you what is to be done. But how will I maintain myself? Narad Muni says, do not worry, I shall supply your food every day. Narad Muni thus advised the hunter, return home, and even the previous balance, whatever he has, distribute all the riches to the pure Brahmanas who know the absolute truth. They will absorb all the sin you give them. After you have distributed all your riches to the Brahmanas, you and your wife should leave home, each of you taking only one cloth to wear. I mean, I remember when I came to Brahmachari Ashram, I didn't know how the systems in this temple work. So I made sure I have 1 year's dhoti kurta supply, toothbrush, toothpaste, soap, everything. This is a real story. I didn't tell the authorities, but I kept in my bag and I kept it. Okay, you know, I'm not sure they will tell me to go and beg for it or what they will tell. I was not sure. There's a department, you just pass a slip there and you get it. So he was told, just take one cloth. That's a family here, you know. You take your wife also and take one cloth. And Prabhupada says, this is the process of renunciation at the stage of Vanaprastha. After enjoying household life for some time, the husband and wife must leave home and distribute their riches to Brahmanas and Vaishnavas. One can keep his wife as an assistant in the Vanaprastha stage. The idea is that wife will assist the husband in spiritual advancement. In Krishna consciousness movement, there are many young couples engaged in the Lord's service. Eventually, they are supposed to take to Vanaprastha and then sannyas. And then he says, you go and build a cottage and constantly chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra in front of Tulsi plant. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram, Ram. Then it says, this is not at all difficult. One simply has to follow the instructions of spiritual master strictly, then everything will be successful in due course of time. As far as eating is concerned, there is no problem. If Krishna supplies everyone with eatables, why should he not supply his devotee? Sometimes a devotee will not even bother to construct a cottage. He simply goes to live in a mountain cave. One may live in a cave, in a cottage, beside a river, or in a palace, or in a big city. In any case, a devotee can follow the instructions of spiritual master and engage in devotional service. By watering the Tulsi plant and chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare. And then Prabhupada writes, what is our life all about? Taking the advice of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and our spiritual master, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj, one can go to any part of the world and instruct people to become devotees of the Lord. By following the regulative principles, worshipping the Tulsi plant and continually chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. And this is the kind of story which was, now it is mentioned, go in the footsteps of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In the footsteps of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Now if you see Lord Chaitanya, since Gaur Purnima was just there recently, last week, Lord Chaitanya's pastime, when Lord Chaitanya meets his devotees, Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu meets in Jagannath Puri, and he gives them a farewell, he says goodbye, he tells them go to Bengal. So the every devotee, now look at the devotees who are involved. Srivas Thakur is there, Advaita Acharya is there, Nityanand Prabhu is there. The first, when he calls Advaita Acharya, actually they have very nice pastimes there in Jagannath Puri. One pastime where on Janmashtami, Advaita Acharya and all the devotees, they take, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself take a rod, and then with the pots of milk and I guess yogurt is there, and they all carry and go and do a major festival there. All the devotees are carrying. They become like cowherd boys. They dance. And when Lord Chaitanya himself is carrying, all the devotees are carrying and they are dancing. And in that, it is mentioned at one point, Advaita Acharya says, you are dancing like a cowherd boy if you can take the stick and spin it and whirl it at your back, in your front, on your side, under your legs, on all sides, then I will believe you are a cowherd boy. And Lord Chaitanya takes the challenge. And Lord Chaitanya takes the stick, spins it, whirls it, rotates it in all directions, behind him, front of him, on the sides, below the legs. Nityanand Prabhu does the same thing. Advaita Acharya, everyone claps. Very good. Hari Bol. Please clap for Lord Chaitanya. So they are having all these wonderful pastimes in Jagannath Puri, and then finally Lord Chaitanya says, now you go to Bengal. Lord Chaitanya discusses something with Nityanand Prabhu. In fact, on Dashara day, they all become like monkey soldiers. And they climb on the wall, and Lord Chaitanya, as if he is climbing on the Lanka and he is going to kill the Ravan. One place there is a very nice quote on Ravan and Ram. It says, Ravan aur Ram mein vartalap hua aur Ravan ne Ram ko bola. Ravan ne Ram ko bola, tu jeeta kyunki tera bhai tere saath tha, main hara kyunki mere bhai ne mujhe chhod diya. Vibhishan chhod ke gaya, main haar gaya. And we have a saying, ghar ka bhedi lanka dae. Ravan said, mera bhai mere saath nahi tha, main haar gaya. Then the quote goes further, it says, very important for all of us to learn. It says, ped ke katne ke kisse nahi hote. Ped ke katne ke kisse nahi hote. Hagar har kulhari ke piche lakdi ke hisse nahi hote. Which means that lakdi is coming from the wood of the tree and is the cause of cutting the tree. So sometimes the external person is not the cause of, like Srila Prabhupada said, our danger to our movement is not from outside, it's from inside. And sometimes it is seen, one person inside is criticizing another person, one person inside is finding fault with another person, because everybody has a different style of living. So, ped ke katne ke kisse nahi hote, agar kulhari ke piche lakdi ke hisse nahi hote. So, that wood is the cause of cutting the tree. Anyway, that's a side thing. So Lord Chaitanya is in Puri and he is having all the beautiful pastimes of Ramayana, and like monkeys, they are all jumping. And finally, the time comes when they all have to go back. Talking about Vanaprastha here, look at what and Prabhupada says, what is our instruction wherever you are, either you are in this city, that city, in New York, wherever you are, all those things are mentioned, any part of the world. What do? You teach people, sit in front of Tulsi and chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And that was the Vanaprastha for Mrigari. And at one point, I'll come back to Lord Chaitanya, but at one point, Mrigari starts getting lot of food. And later on, Lord Chaitanya asks, what are you doing? So he returns all the food. He says, I do not need so much, just simple. But he's getting so much food. So Mrigari says, my spiritual master is sending all this food. And then Prabhupada writes in the purport, he says, so Lord Chaitanya instructs us, he instructed his servant Govinda. I'll read that as it is. Yeah. When Lord Chaitanya's personal servant Govinda sometimes kept a stock of Harita ki, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu chastised him saying, why did you keep a stock for the next day? And Srila Rupa Goswami and others were begging daily from door to door for their sustenance, and they never attempted to stock their ashram with food for the next day. We should not materially calculate, thinking it is better to stock food for a week. Why give the Lord trouble by having him bring food daily? One should be convinced the Lord will provide daily. There is no need to stock food for the next day. These are the purports for Vanaprastha Ashram. Now on one side these purports are there, but then on the other side if you see, when Lord Chaitanya is meeting all the devotees and telling them to go to Bengal. First he meets Nityanand Prabhu, or first he meets Advaita Acharya and tells him, you go to Bengal and go and preach there. Go and preach to the lowest of the people. Distribute the mercy of the holy name. Then he calls Nityanand Prabhu. Same instruction. Then he calls Srivas Thakur. He says, go to Navadvip, go to Bengal, stay at your house, perform congregational chanting and let this mercy go everywhere. And on one side, we have these kind of purports. On one side, then Lord Chaitanya calls Shivanand Sen and tells him that please take care of Vasudev Dutt. He says he doesn't know how to manage his expenses. Whatever he gets, he spends the same day. He doesn't do any savings. So please you take care of him. So you have two jobs. One thing is take care of Vasudev Dutt and also please get all the devotees every year. You have to arrange all this yatra business. Every year, your job to make sure all the devotees come to Puri and participate in the Rath Yatra. In that, he also remembers Sachi Mata. And he tells Srivas Thakur. Actually, Prabhupada writes in one of the purports. So here we have this Vanaprastha ashram going to the forest, this and that. But the other side, he says how devotees take shelter of chanting congregation and associating with each other. That is their main pleasure. Taking the pleasure in the association of devotees. So Lord Chaitanya takes great pleasure meeting every devotee and glorifying that devotee. And he tells Srivas Thakur, I remember Sachi Mata must be in so much pain. He says, there is not even a single day. I visit Sachi Mata every day. She does not know this. He says, now this is a sannyasi thinking about his mother. So if a materialistic person will think, he'll say, oh, this sannyasi is so weak-hearted, no? He's all the time thinking about his mother. And Lord Chaitanya says, in my madness, I took sannyas. Actually, I'm a mad person. I committed the greatest adharma by giving up my mother, by giving up my duties towards my mother. And I know how much my mother cries for me every day when she offers bhoga to the Gopal, to the Shaligram. And her tears are constantly flowing from her eyes. And when she looks at all the wonderful preparations prepared for the bhoga of the Lord, that time, she thinks, I wish Nimai would be here so that I can offer this bhoga to Nimai. I can offer this prasad to Nimai. And I know how much my mother hankers to offer that prasad to me that time. And I really want to go and honor that. And in my madness, I have done such a big adharma. In fact, one day, it was Vijaya Dashmi day, it was Dashara. One day when Sachi Mata offered the bhoga and she was sitting in front of Shaligram and she was offering bhoga with so much devotion and she closed the eyes and constantly tears were flowing and she was remembering me and that time when the eyes were closed, I went there. This is Lord Chaitanya telling to Srivas Thakur. Please go and tell my mother. This is what happened. So that she should know. When she closed the eyes and I accepted all the prasad. And when I accepted all the prasad, she opened the eyes, she saw everything is empty. And she sees such pastimes every now and then, but she does not believe. Internally, she feels happy and she knows that I have accepted, but still she does not believe because she is not seeing me there. And Lord Chaitanya is highly emotional that time. In fact, at one place it is mentioned, he becomes so emotional that he tries to conceal his emotions and change the topic and starts glorifying another devotee. You know, there was one place it was written. Very beautiful statement. It says, Buzurgon ki aankhon se kabhi aansu tapakne mat dena. Buzurgon ki aankhon se kabhi aansu tapakne mat dena. Kyunki jis ghar ki chhat se pani tapakta hai, us ghar ki diware aksar kamzor ho jaya karti hain. Nice statement. Very important to be taught this also. And Lord Chaitanya therefore is worried. I have caused the greatest adharma and he is offering this. And of course, we don't see him giving up his renounced order and rushing back. And when he offered this to Shashi Mata says, oh, do not say like this. But here, Lord Chaitanya, on one side, we have this philosophy of Vanaprastha and renounced order. But on one side, Lord Chaitanya is showing concern for each and every of his devotee, including his mother. And Lord Chaitanya is, in his heart at least, he is showing that emotion. And when Shachi Mata, he says, when Shachi Mata opened the eyes, she saw the food is not there. And when the food is not there, she thought, either I forgot to offer the bhoga, or maybe Gopal ate all, Shaligram ate all, or maybe some animal came and ate when I had closed eyes. I didn't realize. She's getting all these ideas. She's not sure what's happening. And Lord Chaitanya is offering her prayer, his prayers. And he says, please go and offer this Mahaprasad to my mother, Shachi Mata. So Lord Chaitanya is offering another level of interactions with his devotees, with Srivas Thakur, with Advaita Acharya, with Nityanand Prabhu. And then immediately changes the topic. He starts talking about Raghav Pandit. And then he starts glorifying Raghav Pandit's devotion of how he offers those most expensive coconuts brought from a far off distance just because they are of such high quality, and he wants to offer, although he has a whole place full of coconuts, but he wants to get the best, most sweetest of coconuts. And he starts talking the glories of Raghav Pandit. And then Lord Chaitanya starts in that conversation when he talks the glories of Raghav Pandit, he says, that how, he says, how he brings this coconut, how he offers, and when he offers, sometimes Krishna takes away all the water, and then he removes all that, pulp, malai, that he takes that, and then he offers, and he's outside the room, and offering is going inside, and sometimes Lord accepts all the pulp, and sometimes Lord puts the new pulp there. That's the Mahaprasad. And Lord Chaitanya knows all these wonderful devotional exchanges happening between Raghav Pandit and the Lord, Shachi Mata and the Lord, Nityanand Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, Srivas Thakur. And then Lord Chaitanya starts glorifying Kulinagram devotees, Gunaraj Khan. And there he says, he starts glorifying that how, because Gunaraj Khan in his books wrote a beautiful statement that how Krishna, the son of Nanda, is my life and soul. Therefore, all the residents of Kulinagram are my life and soul. Even a dog, he says, every resident is my life and soul. He becomes so happy about that. And one story I want to mention here is his exchange with Murari Gupta. So this is, he's like saying farewell to all the devotees. Now you're going to Bengal, come next year. But at next, that time he is kind of showing all the affection to each and every devotee. And here is a sannyasi showing affection. And how wonderfully those exchanges with the devotees are taking place. And he tells Murari Gupta that how I tried to preach to you many times, Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. Krishna is the cause of all causes. Krishna is the supreme form full of all opulences. Krishna is full of all the divine qualities. He is the best of all forms to worship. How many times I tried to convince him, and one time he actually got little convinced. And then he went home. And then he went home and he could not sleep because he was thinking. And he came and submitted to me that you have these two dilemmas I have in my mind. You say worship Krishna, but I cannot give up the worship of Ram. So one dilemma is I cannot give up the worship of Ram. And one dilemma is I cannot break your order. Your order is worship Krishna. So I am in dilemma, and please I pray that I want to give up my life right now. Because I do not want to commit the sin of not following your order. Now some similar incidences took place in South India when Lord Chaitanya was with Venkat Bhatt and he is telling him, your Narayan is superior or Krishna is superior? Why Lakshmi wants to enter Rasa Leela? And same incident happened with a Brahmana who was chanting Rama by meeting Lord Chaitanya, starts worshipping Krishna. So we have some of those incidents, but now this incident is Murari Gupta is not able to give up the worship, his worshipable Lord, Lord Ram. And Lord Chaitanya that time, he becomes so happy. He says, actually, I was testing your dedicated, staunch devotion to Lord Ram. In spite of my telling you again and again and again, you could not give up the worship to Lord Ram. And then he glorifies Murari Gupta's devotion, such beautiful devotion and dedicated devotion. He says, actually, you are a Hanuman. How can you give up the service to Lord Ram? And then on one side, another incident we have Vasudev Dutt, who prays to Lord Chaitanya that let all the sinful reactions of all living entities come upon me and all the universe get delivered. So here we are discussing the thought processes of some of the wonderful devotees. And Vasudev says, let all the sinful reaction come upon me. And Lord Chaitanya says, that's fine, we can dissolve all the sinful reactions. But why you have to suffer for that? A bag of mustard seed, one seed falls. And what about the tree? Udumbara tree, which is full of so many fruits, one fruit falls away. Out of so many universes which are there, one universe gets delivered. What loss it is. He says, forget about one universe. If you are praying for the whole universe, even if you say, liberate all the universes, not one universe, all the universes. And there are so many material universes, and then there's a spiritual world of Vaikuntha. He says, Lord has a whole Vaikuntha. He, for your pleasure, just to fulfill your prayer, because you have shown your glance to these living entities, I can dissolve all the universes. And it is like if somebody has a millions of wish-fulfilling cows, what that person has to do with one she-goat? And giving up Maya and giving up the whole material energy and all the universes and just liberating them at one and the whole thing finishes. Not a big loss, because you are praying. And see, that's like for one she-goat, what's the loss if I have millions of wish-fulfilling cows? So these wonderful exchanges of Lord Chaitanya. So first we are reading that how Mrigari is being taught about Vanaprastha. And then Prabhupada says, what is our philosophy? Wherever you are, just teach people, worship Tulsi, simplify your life and chant Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram Hare. And become simple. Like recently we were in a place, we were having some program and this one Mataji, I was thinking, this simplicity has to come as a culture. Like if you go to Rajasthan and Gujarat, some places, people have such love for the cows, which doesn't come in ISKCON by education. You educate a lot, but somebody with the culture it is coming, it's just unique to see that. Which most of us who are not born and brought up in that culture, we just can't understand what that is. That's a unique bhakti. Similarly, bhakti also to Krishna, if it is coming as a culture, it is just different. It's most powerful. But if it's just coming as a, after, you know, 25 years, of course, Lord Chaitanya's mercy, everything can happen. But somebody has just bombarded, okay, worship Krishna. And till last minute, we are just struggling to worship Krishna. It is not so natural. Like, we were in a place doing some program, and this one Mataji from Kashmir. And she was telling a beautiful bhajan. And I was thinking, if somebody from childhood has grown in that bhajan, I'll just read a few lines to you. And it says, it's just so natural. Bhakti is natural. Hopefully, it happens like that. In the culture, it grows, it just becomes so natural. She was singing beautiful. One bhajan she was telling me of Vairagya, and one bhajan she was telling me of how she has learned Krishna's Leela through simple bhajans. Like about Krishna Leela, she was telling a simple bhajan. We hear, you know, in our after college, we come to ISKCON, we hear Shivji wanted to enter Rasa Leela. And she says, you know, this one. एक दिन भोले भंडारी बन के ब्रिज की नारी वृंदावन आ गए. He wants to play kartal. So look at this. एक दिन भोले भंडारी बन के ब्रिज की नारी वृंदावन आ गए. Wonderful, very nice. As a culture, she is hearing this since childhood. And about Vairagya, it was so simple. She is telling about the nature of this world. She says,
Samsar ke logo se aasha na kiya karna jab koi nahi apna siya ram japa karna jeevan ke sumundar mein tufaan bhi aate hain jo unke sahare hai prabhu aan bachate hain.
And this mataji, her son is married and he was sitting in front, and I had another devotee with me, an ashram devotee, and this mataji is telling, aap kitne bhagyavan hai, aap brahmachari ban gaye, aapke mata pita bahut bhagyavan hai. And she is telling, agar mera bachcha bhi iskon gaya hota to main bhi kitni bhagyavan hoti, main bhi piche piche ashram mein chali jati. I was laughing like, and I said, wonderful. I don't know if she was telling to please us or not, but at least it was sweet to hear that. Then she said,
Shri Krishna ki ichha se tu mast raha karna jab koi nahi apna Radhe Shyam japa karna
dava na jama lena. Do not become possessive about this world.
ये देश बेगाना है एक दिन प्राणी तुझको वापिस चले जाना है परलोक में जाने का सम्मान किया करना जब कोई नहीं अपना सिया राम जपा करना इंसान दुखी मत हो प्रभु तुझसे दूर नहीं भक्तों को दुखी होना प्रभु को मंजूर नहीं भगवान को आता है दुखियों पे दया करना जब कोई नहीं अपना राधे श्याम जपा करना संसार के लोगों से आशा न किया करना जब कोई नहीं अपना सिया राम जपा करना.
Those people have grown up with this beautiful bhajan since childhood, and therefore when vairagya and bhakti jnana comes as a culture, it just becomes so beautiful. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Shri Prabhupada ki jai. Samaveda bhakta vrinda ki jai. Hare Krishna.